top of the morning, top of the noonday, top of the evening, top of the night, we are going to continue looking at the Kenneka Jenkins case. Let's go. Let's get started.
As we recap tonight, we know the Crown Plaza had a duty to preserve all relevant information involving the incident that occurred on their property pertaining to Kenneka Jenkins. We know that the police department did not electronically go in and retrieve the data themselves or send a specialized forensic team in. They let the hotel manager turn electronic information over to them on external hard drive and thumb drives. Therefore, no one from the police department can speak to the authenticity or the integrity of the data that they have posted on that website. Also, they came out and spun false narratives. Crown Plaza, Police Department, and Mayor. So, as we continue on tonight, that's some things to think about. Let's go. Let's get into this.
Disclaimer: in accordance to the Copyright Act of the United States of America, sections 106, 106A, 107, and the others, fair use. I have a right to use the videos, pictures, materials, and the like, and etc. for criticisms, comments, new reportings, teachings, scholarships, and research. This information is now a matter of public records in accordance to the United States of America Freedom of Information Act. I will re-answer the question, were some of the images and pictures that you see on here Photoshopped? Yes, they were. How do I know? Because I extracted the metadata from some photos to reveal exactly what was done in Photoshop. So let's take a closer look at this. And it will also, inside this metadata, you will see who did what and what she changed. Okay, while we're looking at this, let's scroll down and look at who actually enhanced, altered, and changed some image. It was Julie. Julie works for Target Forensic Lab, or Target Forensics. And in here you can see she used Photoshop version CS6. Life cycle has expired and ended on that version, but we're going to move on. Julie is certified, and her field. But this is what she did in Photoshop. You can see she masked some things. You can see the layers, what was added per layer. She went from a BMP to a TIFF. And these are all the things that were done by Julie. You see the raw header. Remember, packets of data are sent through networks, are transmitted throughout a network. The medium used could be Ethernet cable, coaxial cable, so on and so forth. So you get to see the binary numbers, so on and so forth on here. But this is all of the information from the metadata once extracted. Now you can see it's revealing who did what, down to the type of operating system Julie was on. And we know Julie works for Target Forensics because it's right here in the report from the police officers. Well, I want you to keep this in mind. Yes, she is certified. However, Julie herself cannot speak to, say it with me, the integrity or the authenticity of the data from Crown Plaza Hotel, because she was not there to collect or extract the data herself. It was handed over to her from the police officers, and the police officers got it from the general manager at the Crown Plaza Hotel. So she can't speak to the authenticity of the data either, nor the integrity of the data. So let's just keep that in mind. And all of that is vital. I'm gonna keep stressing that. Cannot be stressed enough. So there you have it. We are going to end right here tonight. You all have a pleasant night, pleasant day, whatever time zone you are on. Bye-bye.